and welcome to another Ryan Sports Views. Tonight I'm reviewing Toronto FC 3, Columbus Crew 1. We win our first match in Rensselaer Field. The Red Bonanza starts tonight, but it didn't start without some problems, some bad times, some adversity, because in the 40th minute, Pedro Santos crosses the ball in to where Jossie Zardes would be. Chris Mavinga challenges it. Westberg tries to come out, but he pulls back. Chris Mavinga slides in, goes off his left foot and in to make it 1-0 Columbus. And I have to say, Westberg has to come out to collect that. I don't care. Even though we won this game and we demolished Columbus in the second half, in the first half, to me, that goal was still unacceptable to me. Chris Mavinga should not have went like that. Westberg should have came out to collect it. It was easy. It was close. Why he didn't come out to get it is beyond me. The thing here is this. Alex Bono would have came out to get that. Now, I'm not trying to start a goalkeeping controversy here. We won. But the thing is, does Alex Bono have more belief that he could collect those balls off crosses and corners and set pieces? Probably. Is he better at delivering the ball, distributing the ball? No, that's Westberg. If I could put both goalkeepers together and get their best traits in the same goalkeeper, I would, but you can't. I mean, the transfer window's open, but if you try to do that, it'd be a DP spot, and that'd be a lot of finagling. It's not something worth doing. Football ain't going to be perfect in a situation like this. But playing the matchup, should it have been Bono? I don't know, but we won. But it's just something to think about. He would have caught that. He would have claimed that. Mavinga would not have had an own goal on that. I think it would have been a clean sheet had Bono been in goal. He would have claimed that. Simple as. Then, in the 48th minute, Jozy Altidore, right out of halftime. Pozuelo gets the ball from Richie Larea off the wing. He passes it to Jozy Altidore outside of the box. He slams a shot past Eloy Room to make it 1-1. Then, in the 56th minute, Alejandro Pozuelo gets a pass from Richie Larea in the same exact position outside of the box. Takes a shot past Eloy Room to make it 2-1. Then, in the 76th minute, Richie Larea does it himself. He goes down the wing, bombs it in, turns in, is like, hey, I'm going to do this myself. Takes it, five holes, Eloy Room. Nutmegs him, five holes in, whatever you want to call it. And in, 3-1, beat the Eastern Conference leaders. The shots were 10-10 for both teams, but Toronto had 6 shots on goal. Columbus had 3. And that's because we dominated that second half. We ended them. We ruined them. We could not be stopped by Columbus in that second half. That second half was the best half I've seen Toronto play all year. Simply put, the possession was amazing. They won in the possession 56-44. Probably because of that second half. Now, they were leading in possession at the end of the first, but that second half basically sealed the fact they won the possession game, they won the passing game, they won the shots game, they won every part of the game to win on the score. And if they had drawn or even lost, that would have been depressing after that second half. But no, they just went all guns blazing. All guns blazing. With a 544 pass game. With 86% passing accuracy. That's amazing. That is amazing. This is the team I talk about when I talk about this team so lovingly, so expectantly. That is what I'm talking about. I'm talking about passing accuracy, lots of passes, good interplay. That is what I'm expecting out of this club on a weekly basis, on a game-by-game basis. This is what I'm expecting, and this is what we got. This is what I expect out of this team, and they did it. And they didn't even need BMO Field. They did this at Rentschler Field in the Hartford base, home base for this team during this pandemic season in the US of A. This team, they fought hard. They wanted to prove that they were still the team to beat, the elite. As TSN said in the open, this open referenced the match perfectly. They didn't want to give up the tag elite to the Columbus Crew. And they were like, oh, you want to beat us like that? Own goal? All right. You're like a little baby. Watch this. That's what they did. They were like, okay. You want to do that? We're going to change the tactics around to a 4-4-2. Have wingers pushing up. Akinola and Altidore's two striker pairing. There you go. It was a masterstroke by Greg Vanney. This game, masterstroke. Amazing of a game by Greg Vanney. Changing the tactics. And by the way, keep it the same. Stop messing with it, because he's been messing with the tactics this whole regular season since MLS is back. He's been like, oh, I'm going to use a 4-4-1-1. Oh, I'm going to use a 4-4-2. Oh, I'm going to use a 4-3-1-2. All right. Or a 4-3-3. What am I going to do? You don't know. Bag of tricks. Here you go. Here's your card. Don't. Stop messing with it. This is perfect. This 4-4-2 is perfect. The only thing I'd say is maybe give Bono another shot. And Gallagher starts over Morrow. Now, Morrow didn't have a bad game. He didn't get outpaced. But I'd like to give Gallagher a shot. I still think he's a good player. He got a little bit of time in this game. He looked good. But to me, I like Gallagher. I'd like to see what we have in him, especially offensively, pushing up. Because defensively, we know he's good, especially after the last game. Made some good tackles, made some good passes, made some good runs in the last game. I'd like to see what we have in him. I think Morrow's a little bit tired, but I think he'll probably get the start in the next game because of Morrow's age and his fitness levels. I think he will, but we still won this game, so yeah. One on the fouls, 6 fouls to 13. We were the more disciplined team for sure, especially in the second half, which helped us win. We were more disciplined than Columbus because being more disciplined shows you that, hey, we could score these goals. Hey, they're getting flustered by our tactical changes, and they did. That was the amazing part of the second half. Toronto kept going. Columbus was like, okay, what do we do? It's like the first time Caleb Porter actually got tested this year. Oh yeah, they lost. And it wasn't like they lost 1-0. New York, losing to New York 1-0. Yeah, that's going to happen. This, you say you're the best team in the East. We spanked you in the second half, Columbus. He didn't know what to do. He was like a frog in hot water. Was he going to jump out? Was he going to swim? He didn't know what to do. He was like, okay, what do I do? 4-4-2, Vanny's got us. He's overrunning us. What do I do? And nothing. He didn't do anything. He changed players, but I didn't see a tactical change for Caleb Porter. And you're the best team in the East? Ha ha, my God. Shouldn't you be able to make tactical changes? Or, oh wait, they've been playing Cincinnati and Chicago. That would make sense. See, I knew we'd have a chance because I was like, oh, they've been playing Cincinnati and Chicago. They've been playing easy teams. Guess what? I was right. Here you go. L. The first real team Columbus played. L. And yeah, we had a bad first half. That first half was even. The second half, though, all us handed them that L. Dominated them possession-wise, passing-wise, passing accuracy. Everything you could imagine, we defended and we beat them. Dominated them on. So, to me, this game was perfect. Man of the match for me is Richie Larea. Assist and a goal and a secondary assist with a Josie goal. 2 points and really caused that first goal. Larea was amazing tonight. Richie Larea's class, like, this kid, well, he's older than me. Why am I calling him a kid? This man, this player, he is amazing. He is class. This player, Richie Larea, he's going to go places. He's going places. He's going higher, but he's playing so well for us. 4 goals this season, and also equaled his assist total from last year tonight. I can't ask for more. This is a great player in Richie Larea. We have a great player in him, and I knew he was great last year, but he's even better this year. He has worked his butt off to be what he is. He runs so much. He runs until he's out of gas. He can pass the ball. He could cross the ball. He could shoot the ball. This was his coming out party for Richie Larea. You didn't know him by now. Now you know. Amazing player. Man of the match for me. Richie Larea. One last message. If you would like to, please donate to the Lebanon Red Cross. After that tragic explosion a month ago in Beirut, let's help the people of Beirut and Lebanon. Let's help make the world a better place. If you like this video, like it, share, subscribe. You know what it is. Tell all your friends. I'm going to review the Toronto Blue Jays versus Tampa Bay Rays series Tuesday, Wednesday, and maybe Thursday if they need it. I'm Ryan and I'm out. Peace.